Hello, welcome to Wireman's Whimsy. I'm Lorraine, and today we are going to make this just a note card. This card kind of took on a life of its own. I just kept thinking, oh, what if I did this and what if I did that? And this is the final result. But it all started from the bow. So let me talk to you about how I put this together. This is the open weave ribbon in soft succulent and polished pink. And I rarely use ribbon on my cards. I just honestly don't think about it. I use bling a lot. But I thought, what if I made a card with a bow on it? So I just made the bow. So I used the bunny ears, and this one might be a bit too small, but I can always cut more ribbon. So you just make bunny ears, tie them in a knot, and pull your ends through, and there you go. So it started with the bow, and then I thought, now what am I going to do with this bow? I love this bow. I love the two colors together. How am I going to use this bow in a card? So I played with it, and I played with it, and I did a bunch of different things, and I ended up with this bow. So I'm just going to trim the ends up so that they're even, like that. Okay, so it all started with a bow. So then I thought I wanted to use the Wonderful World, which is one of the celebration sets, and the Go-To Greetings, which is a new in the catalog. So I used the Just a Note. I love the different scripts and the versatility of the greetings in here. So I stamped it, and I thought, that's a little bit plain, so where do I go from there? And I used the printed texture 3D embossing folder. But stamping this, I used my finger dauber technique. I don't know where I learned it, probably from my upline Tanya, but you've seen me do this before. You ink up your stamp. You can ink the whole thing or just ink where you want that particular color to go. And then you take a finger dauber, and in this case it's in the soft succulent, and you finger dauber the ink on the pieces that you want to be that color. In this case, I've got polished pink for the flowers, and I've got soft succulent for the stems and leaves. Now, this is not an exact science, and sometimes you get a little bit of the one color into the other color. And sometimes it just blends the two colors together. So I'm going to stamp this down kind of in the middle. I've already run it through the scalloped contour die. So I'm just going to plop this down. So I've run it through the die before I run it through the embossing folder, so that running it through again, it does not flatten the dimension in the embossed image. Okay, so we're done with the ink, because I've already made the greeting and used one of the stylish shapes banner dies to cut it out. So I am going to run this through. I just want the ink to really harden up. It should be, but really to harden up before I put it through. So I've got a 5 3/8 by 4 1/8 piece of the soft succulent, and I've got a 5 1/4 by 4 piece of the polished pink, because I wanted just that little border. So I can put those together. They are just flat mounted. There's no dimensionals on these, and we can go from there. If you wanted to preserve your paper, you could absolutely cut the middle of this one out and use it for something else. With my cardstock, I'm not overly fussy about making sure that I'm conserving it. You absolutely can, but like I say, it's not, I do it absolutely on my specialty paper, the foil, gold or silver foil paper for sure, but not so critical on the cardstock. So I'm just going to lay that down. And there we go. So we need to get back to the card front. And what I need to do before I forget is I need to cut a length of the soft succulent ribbon, because I'm going to feed it through here so that I've got that strip. And I usually forget to do that. So I'm going to take my painted texture 3D embossing folder, and I'm going to pop this in like this. Run it through the machine with the base plate and the thick gray plate to get that going. And then I can thread that ribbon through. And there we go. The embossing folders just add that, just that extra little bit to take a perfectly fine, very simple card, just amp it up to the next level. So I'm going to take the ribbon. I'm just going to feed it through one of the scallops at the top and then the corresponding scallop at the bottom. And then I will fix it down to the back of the card, and then I'm going to dimensionalize this card. So like I say, this card, it was a lot of fun to make. It started from the bow and I kind of went from there, and it did honestly take on a life of its own. It's the most giddy I've been making a card in a long time. I'm like, oh, I can do this. Oh, I can do that. Oh, look at this. So yeah, it was quite funny. Those who make cards will completely understand. Those who don't will go, what are you talking about? So I have done everything I need to at this point to be able to dimensionalize this onto the card base. So I took all of my little sheets that had like one or two corner bits left on them, and I moved them all onto one sheet so I didn't have lots of little pieces everywhere. So let's just dimensionalize this onto the card and just peel all the backs off. I used to keep all the little backs in a little cup on the counter and all of that. And now I just, honestly, I throw them behind me on the floor, but I've got one of those sweepers, those carpet sweepers with the little brush wheels in it. My grandmother had one and she always used to, carpet sweep her living room carpet, with it. And I have one and it works a treat. After I'm finished, I just move my chair out of the way and I sweep everything up. And we're good to go. So it does actually work really, really well. So I'm going to center this. It's very close to the edge. I'm just gonna pop that down. I need to dimensionalize the greeting. So again, use up some of those small bits from the edges. And I usually end up starting a new sheet of dimensionals during Paper Pumpkin, because Paper Pumpkin comes with dimensionals for the kit. So I'm just going to pop this down, making sure it's straight, just a little offset from center. There we go. Okay. Now for that bow that I love, I separated the wings of the bow just so that you can see both colors like that. And I used a sticky dot. So I'm just going to pick that sticky dot up with the bow and then just place it like that. Now the thickness of the bow with the two layers of ribbon, this may not go through the mail. This may have to be a hand delivered card. Okay, and I finished it up because I thought, this is great. What else can I do with this? I used the Fine Sparkle adhesive backed gems, and I just pulled a few off and popped them down. And you can put them wherever you like. I don't always put them in the same place on two cards that are technically the same card. So I just wanted to really highlight the Just a Note. So I popped them on the greeting, and then and pop another one down here just to kind of spread the eye out around the card. So that is my It Started From the Bow card using Go To Greetings Wonderful World, which is a celebration item, and the Painted Texture 3D embossing folder. So thank you so much for watching, and we will create together again soon.